Persona! Fear is freedom!
I feel it slipping!
Subjugation is liberation! Contradiction is free! You pigs and human clothing!
This just beginning.
And you're listening to Chibi No Podcast.
Welcome to Chibi No Podcast.
Podcast. This special review episode.
Brought to you by Awards. Ritz Candy and Arizona Ice
and Doritos and Coke Vanilla.
Don't forget TLC tomorrow. Watch AJ Styles defend the WWE Championship against one and only Dean Ambrose.
So, man, we derailed from what we were going to talk about so fast.
I was talking about it. I was just saying our sponsors, Coke Vanilla, Doritos, Arizona, rinse, repeat. Anyways, we're gonna do review.
We're gonna review the 2016 Game Awards that happened last night, which was December 1st, 2016.
It finally happened.
We're gonna talk about a lot of who won.
What about the Gilmore Girls?
No Gilmore Girls.
Anyways,
okay. Heather has her thing. One thing that I will mention: this was a lot better than the last time we saw it. Not last year. I think the one I remember, what I remember was with when we were at your aunt's house and we got snowed in.
Oh
that
yeah.
I'm just saying.
I know. I'm just saying that's the
it's
one
improved
I remember.
A lot. Like
I'm
now
just
they
saying
have,
from
like,
what I remember.
Real, yeah, they have
yeah,
big hosts.
This is actually like an MTV movie.
So no longer half hour. Rap
it was a big deal.
It was nice.
No longer half hour rap shows of people we don't know about. We got good stuff.
BT Dubs though, the like what Heather said, the sound mix was bad.
It was awful.
Because the music was low and the
music
vocals were too
so
high.
Low.
Oh, you mean when they did the bands? That was horrible.
Yeah,
like when they did the really Doom bad.
Oh, what's it, David?
All I could hear was the drums.
Oh, the
guys are like ripping on the guitar.
No,
like,
Miles.
David's just biased because he doesn't like 8-string guitar.
That one sucked too. But what was worse? I'm just saying they all kind of sucked. But the worst was when they were the very first one when they were rapping. And you couldn't hear the music, and so all you heard were these really loud, really bad rappers.
Did you guys see the comments
really
on that?
Crappy lyrics.
Did you guys hear the comments? People were like, please stop. Oh my gosh, get to the games. This is killing me. Like when it ended, they're like, thank God.
The funniest part of that was like there was this line that says like, yeah, I have a bag full of dicks, and let me put it on your lips. I was like, what the freak? This must be a video game award show. I don't care about this.
I'm pretty sure I heard a line that said I'm gonna drop kick a baby.
Yeah, and Heather's like, what about a baby?
Like, are you kidding me? Did they really say that?
But anyway, let's do introductions because we haven't done that. This is David the Smash Fan.
Mr. Worldwide. Boo, boo, boo.
Smiles your tech guy.
Crazy Mama Heather.
And Jose, the quiet one on his phone.
I'm on a protest. Dark Souls didn't win.
Okay, Dark Souls lame now.
It is. Continue.
Okay, so anyway, let's go over the first part of the night, which was very... that needed to be done was, if you remember last year, they were talking about Metal Gear Solid 5 and Hideo Kojima wasn't there.
Yes.
They remember there's a huge controversy between them and Konami. And so he wasn't there to attend and to accept any awards or anything.
He couldn't.
So, yeah, he couldn't, basically.
They wouldn't let him.
So this year, that's what they started with. They're like,
plebs.
We need to give you this award for everything that you've done for us.
This is the Industry Icon Award, which is the highest honor they can bestow upon an individual in the gaming industry.
It's like the Lifetime
Award.
It was
my favorite part of pretty much the entire awards. That was a beautiful segment that was made, and it was very highly emotional. It was great. He deserves it.
He did.
All the
he
bullshit that he's gone through with Konami and them screwing him. Screw those guys.
Right.
They're asshats. Screw them.
And then he went. He
I
said,
think everybody
you know,
agrees with me on that.
Yes. And my favorite part is like, I love you, Jeff. They're like, oh.
That's cute.
So like, I love you guys and all the fans.
Nice. Yeah.
And then he showed us more.
He's like, when I leave, I got a special gift for you, and everybody all clapping, excited, ready.
And we saw more of Last Stranding.
Death. Yep.
That's Stranding. Sorry.
Last Stranding.
And his trailers make no sense. I still have no idea what the freak's going on.
But you're interested.
Nobody does.
But I'm interested.
But you're interested. God, like it looked good.
You see that guy holding the little tank that has the baby in it.
Yeah.
And then you see when they go through the tunnel, What's his name? Mac.
It's the guy from Hannibal.
Yeah, I can't remember his name.
Something Macable.
Yeah, so he's there, and then like the soldiers around him, they're like kind of strapped into him. They have like these.
Little, yeah, it was weird.
Strands.
It reminded me of like the Matrix when they're like in the little pods.
Oh yeah, yeah, I can see that. I'm interested what kind of game it's gonna be like, but we'll find out.
Third person shooter.
Oh, maybe, I don't know. But either way, whatever it is, it looks really interesting. It looks like he's doing one hell of a job in this game.
It looks
beautiful. It's crazy how beautiful it was.
And they confirmed that this was run real time on the PlayStation 4 Pro.
Remember that. That doesn't mean gameplay. That means it was pre-rendered on the PS4 Pro.
Pre-rendered. So it means it shows it's capable of doing that. The game probably won't look as good.
It won't look that good.
It can do that, but it's not going to be like that. Because then that would be
that's not how GPUs work. That's pre-rendered CGI.
Yeah, but then on top of that, I think it would take up too much memory on the PS4. And
the PS4 will not look like that.
I was going to say, like, 100 gigabytes if it's that big.
One terabyte of memory?
It's not the memory. It's the GPU processing power. It was a gigawatts? Pre-rendered CGI cutscene.
Gigawatts?
But yeah, but that
running
was,
off the PS4 Pro's power.
Teraflops?
But that was great that happened.
Pancakes.
And then you know, they started going off with the awards. Miles, kind of, who won what? Categories.
Oh,
you have
shoot,
the list
sorry.
Oh, no, I have it.
Oh, Heather has it.
And they said that the list on this, too, was anything qualifying from up to November 23rd. So that's, like, why we didn't see anything. Like, you're not going to see Final Fantasy, The Last Guardian, etc. They're just...
Well, Last Guardian's not even out.
Right. I'm just saying that these later games, so it's... These, I think Dishonored 2 is the last game of the year that qualifies for this, I believe.
Yeah, because that came out October,
on
20... Right?
No, it came out on the 23rd.
Okay.
Didn't it?
Yeah,
I don't remember.
Something like that.
And so...
Oh, wait, did.
Here we are. Best multiplayer winner, Overwatch.
Yeah. Which I thought was a really hard decision, actually.
I thought Battlefield 1 might have taken that.
Yeah, I was all hard decisions because it was what? Titanfall 2?
Doom.
Battlefield 1, Gears of War 4.
Doom, really? Multiplayer?
No, Doom was not multiplayer.
Overcooked.
Doom Overcooked.
Oh, sorry, not Doom. Overcooked. I was thinking
and Rainbow
Game
Six
Direction.
Siege.
Yeah, Rainbow Six Siege, I could see that. That was a fun one.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Overwatch, that was pretty, like... I'm okay with that one.
I'm okay with that. Yeah.
Not too bad.
I feel bad for Titanfall.
Titanfall got...
Titanfall's damn good, though.
Didn't get any love.
It got shafted.
Okay, next up.
All right, best sports racing game. Winner was Forza.
You didn't see that.
See, this is the thing. Like, Forza will always win that whenever they're nominated because...
But, hold on. But how they said it was sports and driving game.
Right.
It'd be NBA
and racing.
Yeah, so NBA it'd be K? Like FIFA.
So
it'd be
everything
FIFA.
Else was FIFA, yeah,
FIFA's
not good, MLB,
it's big everywhere.
NBA, yeah. Pro Evolution Soccer. That's what they were up against.
Yeah,
so.
But this is the thing. Like, those games, like, they kind of suck. Like, even if you like the games, like... They really suck.
Yeah, like Studio 10, though, and like these Forza games, those are masterpieces. It's great.
Right.
It's like laughable that it's even competing against.
Right, when I saw Forza 3, I was like,
okay, that's
take
an
it.
Easy win.
Yeah, that was awesome.
It was expected.
All right, next, best family game. This one, I don't think they just kind of mentioned it.
I heard it mentioned.
But the winner was Pokemon Go.
Oh, I think they called it mobile game is what they said.
No, they said best family game.
Weird.
They
I remember them
own,
saying best mobile
game. They
have
a mobile game.
They have a mobile one as well.
Oh, okay.
So
that's
twice?
Why I'm confusing it with.
So it went twice?
Yeah, I got two awards in.
That's cool.
I missed that.
Family game. Yeah, because it was up against like a Lego game, Ratchet and Clank, Skylanders, Imaginators.
Yeah, I thought Dragon
no
Quest Builders
didn't
get it.
Oh, and Dragon
that.
Quest Builders.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Pokemon Go destroyed that. Like, granted, it lost a lot of its like heat.
The other key momentum. To people that enjoy it played it.
Yeah, and
the fan, the bandwagons left.
And they still, and those hardcore players, they're still there.
I've been playing it all day today.
Yeah.
Because I actually enjoy it.
All right.
I didn't care about the hype.
Best strategy game. Winner Civilization 6.
Of course. That deserves it.
Yeah. That, no.
Yeah.
Yeah, all no right. contest.
These ones I'm going to read the
Civ
list.
6 is ridiculous.
Best fighting game. Between Killer Instinct Season 3, King of Fighters, Pokken Tournament, and winner was Street Fighter V.
I'm okay with that.
You know what? I think, like, even though Killer Instinct should not have been in the running because that's an old game, it's just new seasons.
Season 3, yeah.
That's what I think.
I
just
know they added a lot
opinion.
To it, but I agree. That King of Fighters actually played a little bit. It's already cool. But I
did
mean,
you see the
Street
update?
Fighter is way better.
Did you see the update of it, though? Mm-hmm. King of Fighters had a horrible graphics update when it first came out.
Yeah, it didn't look that
good. And
they
fixed it, and it looks a lot prettier.
Because it was running on Unreal 4.
Yeah, it's a lot. I just wanted to put my 2 cents on that. It's a lot more polished.
All right. Best RPG. This is the one that Jose is upset about.
Oh, yes. I was okay with it.
Nominees were Dark Souls 3, Deus Ex, I said that wrong.
You're okay.
World of Warcraft.
I'm a fanboy of it. That's all.
Xenoblade Chronicles 10.
That's a big one.
And the winner was Witcher 3 Wild Hunt Blood and Wine.
And you were upset, Jose, because...
DLC.
Okay, it's so that DLC, it's called DLC, but it's a full game package. And I loved
it. How many hours was the DLC? Because it was pretty long.
Well, to me, the main story is 20 hours, but I put about 40 hours into the DLC.
Here's the thing, though. Dark Souls 3 had the full game release, and then they had a DLC on top of that.
Have you guys played Witcher 3?
Have you played Dark Souls 3?
No, but I know it's a full game. I'm just saying, because if you actually play Witcher 3, you understand. Like, it doesn't feel like a DLC. It's a full game.
Doesn't matter, though. It's DLC. Like, there should be a DLC type thing for it.
Yeah, there's...
What if next year somebody creates a DLC that's awesome and it wins Game of the Year? I'm sure you would complain there.
Yeah, but most DLC's not, like, this big. This is
I know, but, like what I was like I was stating...
DLC category.
Right, yeah, like, what I was stating before... About the Killer Instinct, I don't think it should be in there because it's just DLC. It's a 3-year-old game.
It would be like doing DLC. It would be like Mortal Kombat with their packs of new characters. If that was nominated,
see, to me, that feels like DLC. That's what I'm saying. This is separate than this. This isn't like
Then they shouldn't call it Witcher 3.
I get what you mean, Miles. I get what you mean. It's because I've seen
Gears of War Judgment.
I've seen the reviews and that people think it should be. It's like a standalone game.
Gears of War Judgment. But that's like versus considered a full game. That's a similar way that Witcher.
Yeah,
why people look at it.
But to me, like in the sense of it, anyways, it's a DLC and it shouldn't be considered in the
game. That's okay. That's the argument.
Like if they were to be like, oh, best shooter or like best MMORPG kind of thing, they did Destiny, Rise of Iron, and be like, well, that's
see, I get what you're saying. That this is different than like the Rise of Iron, though.
But I'm just stating.
Yeah, that's the argument, though. That's okay.
It sucks, but
that's we're just stating the argument.
That's something additional from the original retail game that was sent out that shouldn't be considered. For it should be separate, like best, like Diego said, like best.
I think it was
DLC or whatever it might be.
I mean, I don't disagree that Witcher 3 deserved a win, but I don't think it's
just opinion. That's
I think it was more of a payout than anything in my eyes.
Okay, hi Heather.
No worries.
All right, best action adventure game nominees were Hitman, Hyper Light Drifter, Ratchet and Clank, Uncharted 4, Thief's End, and the winner was Dishonored 2.
Really?
I haven't played it, so I really can't judge it. But I
thought
know.
It was Uncharted.
I thought it was Uncharted. That's what I thought. But I think we're confusing that with a different.
Oh yeah,
title.
Yeah, there was another category. One that was like kind of similar. Okay. Yeah.
But I was surprised on that one. I thought Uncharted would have gotten that. But then again, I've never played Dishonored to know. But I mean, it's Uncharted.
I've seen it. I've seen gameplay of it. I've tried like maybe a level or just a part of it. But it looked really fun from the part that I played.
So I don't have. I can't say much on that.
Anyway, could try it. Best action game, exclusively action. Nominees: Battlefield 1, Gears of War 4, Overwatch, Titanfall 2, and the winner, Doom.
See, I thought this one for best shooter. Did they have that category too? Because I thought they said best shooter.
No, this was just best action game. It'll have first shooter.
So if it's just based on action, then I actually do agree with this one.
I think so too. Like, I haven't played Doom, but it looks intense.
For if it's just playing action, this dominates in the action.
It looks intense, so I can't
deny it. It's like going 180 miles per hour, and it never stops for the whole game. So if you're based on just action, Doom takes that. But I say the only thing comes close out of how fast pace and action these are, I'd probably say Titanfall 2.
I would. I kind of side more for Titanfall because I'm a little more biased to it than Doom.
But if you play Doom, you'd understand. It's faster.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't get too much into Doom. Like, I think I played, one or two levels. Mm-hmm. And it was fast. Like, it was fast, but I wasn't
It's a
too,
real Twitch shooter.
Yeah, like that's my thing. Like, I'm not a huge Twitch shooter kind of guy. Yeah. So that's why I didn't get too much into it.
Well, Titanfall's considered Twitch, but it's not
but
like
it's
Doom
not,
Twitch.
Yeah, it's not like Doom Twitch. I'm like, so that's why I'm more biased towards Titanfall 2. I was like, that should have gone. And I think that Titanfall just has been, underrated in a lot of things because it came out in just a terrible time. Horrible. They the way that they released it, right next to Call of Duty, right next to Battlefield 1, like
it was bad timing.
Yeah.
Was anybody happy to see that Call of Duty was never in any of these?
Yes.
Thank goodness.
Despite their 10 out of 10 reviews, Infinite Warfare.
Those are paid reviews. You
paid
could tell.
Reviews, yeah.
Yeah, and you know what I was glad about? And I've heard some people were arguing was people were like, why isn't Modern Warfare on here? But I'm like, that's an old game. It's just a remaster. It shouldn't be on here. It already got its Game of the Year.
Either way,
stuff.
I don't think it stands up to these.
I know, but I was saying, it's already got its acknowledgement. It doesn't need it now. It's just polished. It's nice and pretty. That's
do
it.
That.
It doesn't need to be in it. It's already
right,
shown
it's
worth
category,
it.
All right, next category, best VR game. Nominees: Batman Arkham VR, Eve Valkyrie, Job Simulator, Thumper, and Winter Res Infinite.
Now, do you guys remember what was the one game that I took the headset off when we played the demos? It was Res Infinite. I looked at him like, no, screw that game. That game made me throw up.
Wait, what was Res Infinite again?
It was that.
Is the one that you're following, like, all the little squares type of thing, that and little, then it like, becomes a running man?
Around. Yeah, the running man.
Kind of, like, shooting at it.
We thought it was like Star Fox, it was like where abstract. Anna was running. That one made me almost throw up. That one. So I say, screw you, no.
Batman, or, no.
That I'd probably say
Diego
Batman.
Diego was
for
going
that.
For Thumper there.
No.
Diego could go for Thumper.
No, that game is just long.
It's all right. What's next, Heather?
Next, best mobile handheld. Winner was Pokemon Go. Let's skip to the next one. Best independent game. Best independent game was...
Inside
was the winner.
Inside is cool. Like
that, I'm glad that they won that.
If you never played, sorry, Heather hurt herself. If you've ever played Limbo, on Xbox or I think it's on PlayStation as well, isn't it?
Oh yeah, it's on everything, dude.
Is
on your Android.
Is it your successor or is it like the?
It's just another game that's set. There's controversy if it's the same universe. I've been playing it, and I kind of feel like it is. Yeah. But it was up against Firewatch, so I didn't know who was going to win.
Firewatch
Buy that. I haven't played it yet. Have you guys played it?
I didn't even know what Firewatch was until I saw it. It looks cool.
What do you know about Firewatch? It's like a walking simulator in all sense
it's
of jokes.
It's more about the story than anything else.
Woo!
And I loved Limbo. Like, it was hilarious. Like, we had my friend Wire, who just barely came in here, and him and my friend Brixton, they played Limbo at my house, and I fell asleep because I was like, come on, just go home. And it took them forever to get it done. They were there for like 3 hours to finally finish Limbo. And this and the game Inside is that addicting as well. Like, it's really
good.
Yeah, it's really awesome. Like, I they deserve that win.
So, yeah, I mean, they had The Witness up against it. I was fine with really kind of Firewatch, Inside, or Witness, but I'm glad Inside won.
Yeah,
Playground's amazing.
Next one, Heather.
Playdead, sorry.
All right. This one is the Games for Impact Award.
What does that mean?
Games that mean something. They impacted society somehow.
Oh, this is the one they talked about. Like,
this
yeah,
is the one I
kind of want to
focus
like,
on. Yeah.
Yeah. No doom up in here.
Don't
so,
know.
So let's just talk about the winners because that's going to be the most recognizable. The winner was That Dragon Cancer.
Have any of you guys heard of any of these games?
Yeah,
this one,
in a sense, it was kind of buried by a lot of top title games. But the people who did play the game, they gave it a 10 out of 10 all the time.
Didn't the guy that came out because he's emotional, he said it was like 7-man team or something.
Yeah, well, the thing is...
Okay, so here's the story.
Yeah. What's it about?
This man had a...
His name's Ryan Green. He's a developer.
Ryan?
Ryan Green.
Okay. I couldn't remember his name. So Ryan Green, he and his wife had a cute little boy.
Uh-huh.
And at 12 months old, the little boy was diagnosed with cancer.
Terminal.
Oh, God.
Terminal cancer. And so it's kind of
it's
him
your story.
Working
you're
through,
playing through their story.
Yeah, we're playing through their story of cancer with this child and yeah.
Yeah, wow. That's where all that emotion came
there's
from.
This, there's
he deserved
this,
that then.
Yeah,
damn.
People were
this is
really
part of the,
happy
of his
about
speech
it.
That I want to.
It was
wanna,
a, one of the most beautiful award like speeches I've heard.
Yeah,
because
yeah,
I was curious.
He's
like,
very
why
emotional.
He was
this is
crying.
One part that I want to quote of what he said in his speech. He said, "You let us tell the story of my son Joel." He says, "In the end, it was not the story we wanted to tell, but you chose to love us through our grief by being willing to stop and to listen. And to not turn away, to let my son Joel's life change you, because you chose to see him and experience how we loved him. And I have hope that we are all willing to see each other, not just for who we want to be, but who we are and who we're meant to be. This act of love and grace can change the world. Thank you."
And this was a Kickstarter, I believe.
Yes.
And it was powerful.
That's beautiful.
Like his speech, like the announcers and everyone, they're kind of getting teary. I was like, I was like, oh, man.
I was getting teary from it, too. It was kind of cool to see because it's like this is kind of the thing where it shapes into, like, games being more than just games that, like, the – what do you say? Like, you know, the people that don't play games are just like, I'm like a waste of time. Like, they don't really understand how there's this bigger art meaning or this bigger –
This shows you that this has a deeper meaning.
It has a deeper meaning. Like, this can show you what real things can be out there, you know. And this – you know, most people think of, like, Madden or Call of Duty where this is, like, real stuff, you know. And I thought it was a beautiful speech.
Big impact. I loved it. Ryan Green, yeah, we send our love to you and to your son, John. I'm pretty sure he's happy up there, too.
Yeah.
No, his game won and his game changed a lot of people.
It's beautiful.
All right, next, Heather.
All right. Next was a category that Uncharted basically had in the bag. It was Best Performance. There were three nominations for Uncharted 4. Elena, Nathan, and Sam. And the winner was, of course, Nolan North as Nathan Drake.
Did anybody think that maybe Troy could have taken that home?
I was hoping, but Nolan North just killed it.
It's Nolan North. And you know what? He deserves it.
Yep.
And I know you guys have played Uncharted 4 and saw, and it was just wow.
I haven't played 4. I've played up to 3.
Oh, I was looking at them.
Yeah, I know. But I've played up to 3. And I loved it. I need to play the fourth one, but
it's
Nolan
amazing.
North is bomb.
He's Nolan North.
I hope Troy Baker can get the next one, that he comes out with a huge DLC role for next year and just like...
Ugh. Hey, it could be The Last of Us. Here's hoping.
Heather, what's next?
All right. Best Music Sound Design.
And I agree with this one. 100%.
Nominees were Battlefield 1, Inside, Res Infinite, Thumper, and the winner was Doom.
Yes, and well-deserved.
It's an intense soundtrack.
I remember when I first turned that on, the music kit, when I played that, bought that game, I was sitting there just bobbing my head like, this is awesome.
What's funny is they wrote it really simple, like, though. If you see, like, the guitar parts he was writing,
yeah,
it's super simple.
But it's kind of like Blink, where it's, like, catchy, like, simple
yeah,
stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
And it was
it's
good.
It's produced by Diego's favorite band, with two of them, right?
No. The drummer, he's...
Just the drummer?
Yeah, the drummer helped compose the drumming parts. Like,
he's
the main
from
beats.
Periphery, right?
Yes,
from what?
Matt Halpern from Periphery. He's a progressive metal band.
Okay.
But yeah, he'll be part of that.
He's funny to watch. We watched him play.
When he drums,
he's
afraid.
What's funny is his drum set. Yeah, he's tall and his drum set is like way low. So he looks like he's like...
Like a giant.
Like, he looks like,
yeah.
it's like he's
trying to slap his knees. It's like he's trying to slap his knees. And when he drums, he kind of looks like he's afraid of it. He's like this.
It's the funniest thing. They can't see that.
I wish people could see Diego's face right now.
And he has he's notorious for having like the deep V neck. Like it'll be like down his belly button kind of thing.
Deep V, disgusting.
Double V.
No, but like he has deep V's. Like
I know, but
double V.
Nasty
deep V's. Yeah, he does.
Deep V's.
Yeah,
I had it.
Anyways, let's get next.
Sorry.
Best art direction.
I think we're looking at the same
nominees. Abzu. Firewatch, Overwatch, Uncharted 4, and the winner was Inside.
I actually thought Overwatch would have gotten our direction.
I thought Overwatch.
I thought too.
That or Firewatch. Firewatch or Overwatch.
I think this
Overwatch.
Is what it was. I think Overwatch would have won it if it was strictly PC, because like you want to see how the game looks in different consoles.
It looks
consoles.
Like Pixar.
I know, but if you look at it through different consoles, it kind of deteriorates from what PC is. If it was straight PC, I think Overwatch would have won that too. But, you know,
I thought Firewatch could have brought that home. Inside was number 3, but I thought it would have been Overwatch or Firewatch.
I think the thing is Inside was kind of simplistic, but it showed all the shadows and all the...
Well, if you play the game, too, I think they're looking at more than just not prettiness. I think they're looking at really like the art direction of like how they make
the atmosphere. That's
right,
because all the other games are super pretty and colorful, and this one's kind of
where this
like,
one's dark and dreary, but it's also... It's really the background is the story.
There's depth to it.
Because there's no narrative in that game. It's the background that's telling the story. Right. And that's what's so amazing.
It's basically what is the art expressing when you're playing?
Yeah. The art expresses the story, where Overwatch or Firewatch is... They just look pretty.
Yeah.
It's so beautiful.
But this is like, it's cool.
All right. I'm going to jump back down for a second. The most anticipated game was actually an award given last night. The nominees were God of War, Horizon Zero Dawn, Mass Effect Andromeda, which we saw a preview for.
Yes.
And it looked really cool.
Right?
But it kind of it reminds me of No Man's Sky.
Yeah.
Except Mass Effect.
And better.
Yeah, it's like more colorful on like some of the planets they're on. But we only got to see that one gameplay in that one planet.
Yeah.
So I'm sure we'll have some others. Yeah. But what they showed, it looked like No Man's Sky,
beautiful.
But wow, does that look beautiful. That was running on PS4 Pro, I believe. Rendered
I don't know.
Checkerboard 4K.
Those techniques that they had, the special attack, was awesome.
Yeah, like the one where he is kind of... What did that guys remind you? Oh, that's what it reminds me of. Kind of like the Final Fantasy where like he could like zip and go on top.
I call it the Mass Effect blink.
Yeah, he's like blinking, I guess, in a way, but it looks ridiculous.
The other nominee, Red Dead Redemption 2. And the winner was The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild.
Holy crap!
That preview, like, for the game, like, I thought it was going to be kind of stupid because you had the two guys on the couch playing. But, man...
Can we talk about Zelda for a sec?
Yeah, go ahead.
That's why I jumped back down.
Yay!
So before this moment where we... Yeah. When, well,
10
when
minutes before that, they showed the trailer for it.
They released a trailer for it. So in the trailer, there's, like, this little teaser of possibly seeing Zelda in it.
But she's wearing the same tunic outfit that
I thought they're gonna show Zelda.
But
right
they did.
But they did it. They cut it.
And he bows to her. He kneels to her, though. So
it's Zelda. Like,
yeah.
Yeah, and then we get to see the preview of the actual gameplay, we don't get to see what's at the shrine. That's what I was like, come on, just go to the shrine.
That's what is right there.
They gave you a lot of information, which I liked. Like, they could show you he could climb. It looks like he could climb anything.
The climbing was cool. Jump
climb. We saw the climbing, and we're like,
you guys freaked out.
Yeah, because when he was climbing,
like, yeah.
That's when you look at me like it's.
He's like, this is Dark Souls.
Well, what's funny is it looks like he can climb anything, because what he looked like he was climbing didn't look like you could climb it. So I was like, whatever.
Yeah, that pick, how he did the pick and the jumping. I mean, yeah, doing Uncharted and Tomb Raider, but this actually, this game you guys haven't played, it's Edge of Nowhere, which is a VR game made by Insomniac, sorry, Studios, and how he does the pick for it just like that, and it's extremely helpful. But I like that the picking isn't like super tedious and long. He just kind of went right up and got right in the
edge. Right, and you have your little stamina bar.
Oh,
That takes like a quarter.
Oh yeah, and you have to eat.
You have to eat.
Your wait, health. Explain the eat. I didn't notice that.
So he pauses.
Started to go down. Uh-huh. He paused the game. Ate some food and his health went
back
up.
That's what he was doing.
Oh, or maybe you can't pause him.
But he has
real
tons
time.
like you saw like. Tons of boxes with different foods. Some of them said full recovery, others said like half or partial. Quarter. So it was cool. Yeah. The gameplay was awesome. Like it had the kind of like the time. What's it called? The time.
Time of day.
No. Where it slowed down and said hit A. And,
that like slow motion effect.
Yeah.
Where it like slows down time, so you can kind of like do those.
Quick movement.
Yeah,
attack
quick time
things.
Play or something.
She
like
that. Did that one where he's doing like a combo move a few times. That looked really cool.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about. Also, what I liked too was when he did pause and go to his inventory, Link had a different outfit on too. It seems like you can customize his look, so it's not just
the bomb
one look
cool.
Or the other thing. Because it looked like he had like a little red rocky tunic on his body.
I'm pretty sure from what we looked at, because obviously the trailer is much improved from what we've seen before. I'm pretty sure this is running on the Switch, obviously.
But no, it can, but it
showcase
looked,
the footage.
It looked like they're playing on the Wii U. I think they're trying to show.
No, yeah. I mean that. I mean when they actually show the trailer, not the game.
Yes.
Trailer looked better than the live gameplay, obviously.
Yeah. The thing I didn't like is he's right-handed. Needs to be left.
Oh God, shut up.
Link is left-handed.
Don't care.
But what was the other thing they did? Like they showed kind of the little mini boss fight.
Oh yeah,
the little. I like the little bombs that he kind of like. I don't know what it is. It just was blue. And
enemies
just,
are smart
too.
It was
a cool looking villain.
The enemy
though.
Was dodging it.
Yeah, he's like, would walk he's like, come on.
Oh
walk
yeah,
to
he's
it.
Like, did he
walk
just dodge it. That? And he's like, he's coming. He's like, oh crap, what the heck? The AI actually had really good AI in Zelda for once.
Yeah,
which is exactly why Jose was like, this is Dark Souls.
He's gonna
because
say it, you died.
The fighting style kind of paralleled it.
Yeah,
and the boss.
All great games are inspired by stuff, right? I mean, most games are inspired by Halo nowadays for shooters or Call of Duty, so.
Yes.
Dark Souls, that's a good mention, dude. You get some Dark Souls in your Zelda. It's not a bad thing.
All right, what's next?
We have three more categories. Next is Best Narrative. Nominees, Firewatch, Inside, Mafia 3, Oxenfree, and the winner, Uncharted 4, A Thief's End.
Obvious.
I thought Firewatch was going to win this, actually.
Really?
Because the narrative was... Interesting pacing in Uncharted.
Was it like just slow?
Very slow.
That's what
I know Firewatch is like. I mean, Firewatch is like a slow walking, but I hear the narrative is basically what sold that game. Where Uncharted, you know, it's a little more the characters and the fun adventure finding treasure. But I mean, I'm fine with it. I love Uncharted. I just didn't know if maybe they pull ahead. But I want an Uncharted.
I don't know. Like that one. Like of all the ones that Uncharted was nominated for, like. You know, like best action one, I was like, that was always gonna win. That's our best narrative for me was like a no brainer. Like I've seen Firewatch, it looked like the pacing and everything. The fandom is huge and reviews are great. But I was like, I
still haven't
sure
played it to know though.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure that Overwatch
Uncharted
was gonna win.
Yeah, I'm fine with that.
Yeah, go on.
Okay, best game direction. This is for.
What does that mean?
Oh no!
Help me, Heather. What's best direction? Game direction mean? Do you know? I didn't understand this award.
I don't think.
Basically,
it
would be like.
Where's the game? Where's the game being taken? Like what?
Well, not just that, but also like, how well put together. Like, basically, production value. I would say.
Yeah, that's when I heard this one. Like, what award is this?
I think it's more production value.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So who are in there?
Okay, nominees, DICE for Battlefield 1, ID Software for Doom, Naughty Dog for Uncharted 4, Respawn for Titanfall 2, and the winner, Blizzard for Overwatch.
Sure.
See, I was like,
I didn't know anything about the award.
I was actually kind of surprised by that.
I was thinking
DICE
was gonna get it. DICE or Naughty Dog.
I'm actually really well. I don't want to spoil anything yet, but you can. Oh wait, no. Yes, I can because it's not nominated for that last award. I was really surprised Battlefield 1 did not win one award.
Yeah,
because literally too. That game is blowing up.
Huge. I'll tell you this much. Like, I hate the type of shooter that Battlefield is. Like overall, like that. Like in general, that I hate that type of shooters. I will admit, like when I played the game, I think it was like for 40 minutes or an hour. Like it was way fun. Like I couldn't put. I was like, this is good. Like, yeah. And I was like, oh no, I should play Overwatch. I was like, okay, let's go back to Overwatch. But Battlefield like kept me occupied. I was like, this is fun. And it didn't feel like I wasted half an hour on one game.
Yeah.
I was like, half an hour went through? What the freak?
Yeah. Some of those games like the Operation map where it's like a huge. It can take you an hour and a half. To be a multiplayer match.
Yeah, and it doesn't feel like that.
No,
it
you feels feel like you just played like a huge minutes. Campaign, but you felt satisfied. It's
yeah.
Anyways,
so I just yeah, Battlefield not winning is a huge surprise too. Like
not one.
Yeah,
I thought it could have got multiplayer game of the year even.
But Overwatch won that.
Yeah. No, I'm saying I thought it could have won it, but it's because it's unbelievable.
All right, what's next, Heather?
All right, and the last category, game of the year. Nominees were Doom, Inside, Titanfall 2, Uncharted 4, A Thief's End, and the winner, which was a huge surprise.
This was actually really
this
Overwatch.
So let me.
I'm proud for them. But that's not what I thought was going to win.
Maz, let me tell you what happened here. So we're here watching the awards.
This is your live reaction.
Imagine
right?
this.
Okay.
Baby's in her swing. She's swinging along, sleeping.
She's like sleeping.
We're sitting there going, okay, well, you know, I think Uncharted 4's got it. And then
what was Jose doing?
Jose was like, "Oh, Uncharted 4's got to have it. I mean, yep.
It's Uncharted.
The last one. It's Uncharted. It's Uncharted. Like, they're good." And then all of a sudden, they say Overwatch. And me and David go,
and the baby like,
and the baby wakes up.
But the baby didn't make a noise. She just
she
like,
just opened
happened?
Her eyes and looked around and was like, "What happened?" And
so what did these two
out.
Do when they heard it? What was Jose and Diego's reaction? Like, they're all on the phone in the middle of a recording.
No, I'm listening. I was the same way, but I was like, oh, quiet, guys, quiet.
What? Jose, what did you say?
He's like, okay.
Yeah, when I was watching it by myself, I was like, listen, I'm like, oh, yeah, Uncharted, of course, duh. And then it said Overwatch. I'm like, wait, what? And then I literally said, well, that's cool. That's awesome. But wait, what? Like, I was
right. I mean, for me, definitely my game of the year.
Yeah, totally.
My personal game of the year. What's funny is that within like 2 minutes on Facebook, hashtag not my game of the year pops up and people start saying no.
It's not my game of the year. Uncharted is my game of the year, but I'm proud of Blizzard. I mean,
let's
Overwatch. It's amazing.
Let's talk about this huge controversy because in within our general localization in Utah, we have a Facebook page, Utah Gamers. Now they were a lot of people were livid. They're like, how the F did this game beat out, you know, Uncharted? Like, it's no way. Like, this is bull crap. And I was like, and so there's a huge, like, thread of, like, people way against it and people for and supporting and saying, this is why it won. It's like, no, this is why it shouldn't have won. And, like, we gotta face the fact that there have to have been some other factors that came into play for this being Game of the Year other than just the multiplayer on it. Because, let's face it, like, the multiplayer itself is just, you know, you do capture location.
It's really simplistic when you really put it down.
But let's look at what Blizzard has done in the game. First of all, they made this huge push with all these CG trailers that made you get invested in this story that we still don't really know much about.
And we're still interested. And they keep delivering.
And they keep delivering despite them, you know, with these frustrating Sombra stuff that happened. Like, well, it's gonna release this time. Nope. This time, nope.
Sombra's
we cracked the code 100%. Oh, it's just this email. Like, they've kept people like interested in this game. On top of that, we've had this big push in esports. Peach? And you know, in esports, Peach? You know, Counter Strike 2, League of Legends, and StarCraft like dominate esports. And now you start seeing Overwatch start being played, and it's starting to bring in these huge numbers of people watching it, and it's fun to watch. Like I have fun watching, you know, Overwatch competitively. I also love watching Counter-Strike too. Counter-Strike is just amazing watching competitively, but Overwatch has had this huge just picked up a lot of steam.
It blew up quick.
Right. But now and then, so I'm pretty sure those came into factor to make it win Game of the Year. if it didn't have any of that, then I would be completely on their side saying like this shouldn't win because A Thief's End had great story, it had great great narrative, it had Nolan North obviously, and people just praised the heck out of it. Titanfall 2 had a great campaign, has great multiplayer, and you know you were expecting that campaign when Titanfall 2, I wasn't expecting it to be that good. You know,
it was fun, but unlike compared to Uncharted, it's still not there.
Right, still,
but it was fun.
And then we have Inside, which was just very simplistic, but it was just beautiful to play.
This is how I feel about it.
Bullshit.
Let the boss speak now, Miles. Uh-huh. We're talking big boy talk now. Okay. This would be like Titanfall winning last year. Didn't have no single player. It had awesome multiplayer, but obviously Overwatch is bigger than Titanfall was last year.
Obviously.
But that's how I feel about it. You know, this game doesn't feel, if it's a good game, I play it. I play it a lot. Mm-hmm. But it just doesn't feel like Game of the Year material because it doesn't have everything.
I would say this is how I look at it. It's fan favorite Game of the Year.
Yes.
But
yes.
Of deserving, no. I am sorry, but Uncharted took, 4 or 5 years to make. They have the best writers, the best art directors, the best... the best voice actors, mocap, money, showing the passion of games, showing these stories that take forever to make, and it's pure art, and it is an inspiration. Yes, they do have a lot of work that goes into Overwatch, I get that. Mm-hmm. But when it comes to it, I agree. It is point A to point B, you have some fun on the multiplayer maps, that's it.
Yeah.
Now, I think they're looking at it on the side of like, yeah, it launched this, you know, you got your esports, lots of biggest multiplayer of all time, but when it really comes down to a game factor... I think
it
the
needs
better
to
package
have everything in yes. it. It needs to have every category, like the story, your art, your depth, your all of it. And then Overwatch only had maybe like 60% of that.
Yeah.
Whereas,
in a sense, I feel like it's kind of like a music video winning, you know, movie of the year type of thing.
It could be
like really good. It could be high protection value, but it doesn't have everything that needs to be there.
It's
in
not,
my opinion,
it's not a complete package. It is. And on me, I'm happy that it won. I love Overwatch. They deserve to get recognition.
Yes.
But I'm sorry, as for a gamer and the gamer community and how games are made, Uncharted holds the title.
I do agree with you on
but
that.
But I'm fine with the winner. It's
like,
just awkward
to me. Yeah. It kind of feels like the DLC thing. It feels like it's not complete, like you said.
It's like almost it's like an extremely good free to play that you don't have to buy anything unless you're Diego.
Weird is it's like I hear you.
You bought loot boxes.
Hundreds of loot boxes.
Yeah,
hundreds.
Okay,
like
so this
nobody's saying that the game is bad. I mean, nobody should.
No, that's what I'm saying. We all respect Overwatch. It's like our favorite game of the year. Like for like. Having fun and multiplayer.
Just,
enjoying,
it was just weird for it to be in that category against all those other names.
I wasn't expecting it in the category at all.
It shouldn't have been in that category.
That's actually another thing. I don't think it should have belonged in the category.
Right. So this is the
That's why I'm saying
the question that comes up now
in that category,
is
period.
What criteria now should they change for Game of the Year? Because again, I think all those factors that I mentioned before had to have played a part in them winning. Now the question is. Should they take that away? Should the impact or
what's done is done. You cannot go back.
No. I'm not saying take away what they've done now for future, for installments, for next year.
That's what we're saying.
Yeah,
well, in the future.
Should they take that away? Be like,
no. Well, the problem here is that what is a game? You know, because Walking Dead won Game of the Year.
Telltale games.
Well, yeah, so that's minor one. Production. Great storytelling, but minor production.
And you don't really play too much. It's more
there's
like
Journey was also in the debate for Game of the Year
But that's just a remaster.
No, not this year. I'm talking
about in the past. And Journey did win Game of the Year, I thought.
And some of them did.
In a way, I can see that one, though.
Yeah, I think it's just a weird thing
just
to be in.
Here's an example. Explain to me, why would you say Journey could have got Game of the Year back in the days? Why?
For me, it would be just...
It's like Inside or Limbo,
right? Yeah, it's a story, but it's different.
In an art-directive way that is meaningful.
And that
to
one
each.
Doesn't have multiplayer, right? No. You could still play with people, but it's not multiplayer. So it just kind of depends.
It's in
it's
a weird gray. It's a weird gray area to be in. And I think just like, but the thing is, the people that they were choosing the categories of who was going to be in that nominee, Overwatch was the odd man out in that weird perspective. You know what I mean?
For me, it's kind of like if, like I said, if Titanfall would have won last year, you know, people would have.
Flipped out.
It would have flipped out, but to me, it would be kind of like Smash Brothers or Street Fighter winning Game of the Year. So it just doesn't feel. It's definitely like you could say that it's up there. You know, you could nominate it, but to win for it, like it, a fighting game, I would never say Game of the Year. A racing game, I would probably never say Game of the Year. It's maybe just the type of mentality that we have. mm-hmm. growing up with you know, storytelling. Here's, or maybe it's just the
here's one a good we example. Put into it. Here's a good example. Like, I think was it last year? Or the, no, it was the year 2014. No, no, no. 2014, I believe.
With, 3 years ago.
Terrible year.
No, hold on. I'm not talking about that. 2014, I believe, which that was Witcher 3's year, right?
Yeah.
Now, when you look at a game like that...
Was it already...
Was it, yeah, I believe so, wasn't it?
It was 2014.
2014.
Wow, that's crazy.
Because, yeah, so the thing... Because 2013 was Tomb Raider. No, then Witcher would have beat that
correct,
easily.
Correct.
So, anyway, so when Witcher came out, now that to me is a game of the year.
It had a lot of
game.
It didn't have multiplayer, but it had a lot
no,
of
no, and it didn't, but it was art directed. It was narrative. It was story. It yes. was characters. It was the tech behind it. It was... The gameplay, it was every damn thing. The engine, the optimization.
Correct.
It is amazing. That's why I'm saying Overwatch is just like, it's like mm-hmm. Halo 5's multiplayer put into a $60 package and say, here's your game of the year. Like, it no, that doesn't work that way. I'm sorry.
Yeah,
it doesn't, it doesn't have that.
Like I was saying, it was in a weird area and it shouldn't have been in the nominees compared to all these titans.
Yeah, go back in history. Be. That doesn't go in the fitting.
I think just the way, like I said, because of its influence...
Yeah, that's probably why.
That's why I feel at the very least
the hype went through the roof for it. That's probably
why. At the very least, that's why
it
should be nominated.
It blew up.
Yeah, and that's a good thing. It's not bad.
What's funny is like if you read like the comments, especially for PC ones.
I've read the comics. It's great.
No. For like no, I've heard like people's like fans, critics like it's lower than what the score that most people give. Like magazines give. It's kind of weird. Like they have like scores like in the low 70s.
Well, you know, GameSpot, or they hate every game.
I hate GameSpot. Don't hate every right? GameSpot. But
Uncharted 4, I'll give it a 7.
They
it's
gave
cool.
they gave what
or Final
Fantasy 15.
They gave it an 8, which is fine. But
people freak out. Like I see people online, they're like, "Oh, the game only got a 7.6." Like, oh, no. Or the game only got an 8.2. I'm not gonna play it. I'm like, are you kidding?
Stupidest.
That's a good game. Like,
there's a lot of games that who it depends it on who's reviewing them. Because like with
hashtag
IGN. With IGN, like, you got to be thinking about who you
yeah,
who
that,
you
that game
reviews
is
on.
Yes, because scores suck.
It's
find a reviewer you like, hear their opinion that you trust, and go by that.
Right? Who's the one
or
that
go by
find
your friend?
Find the one you agree with.
Exact same one.
Yes, Ryan.
Find one that you agree with. If
Ryan
you
McCaffrey.
See them and you start saying, "Oh yeah, I agree with this person's review of this,
they think like you. They have
that
mentality.
Yes, follow someone that has the same mentality as you. Ryan McCaffrey is mine. There's a lot of controversy. People call him the Xbox fanboy, the Halo love boy. Yeah, well, I like him because he said the same was Halo 4. When I landed back on that the Dyson Sphere and that planet, and it felt like the opening of Halo 1, and it made me feel just like I was back in 2001 again. That's the exact same line he said. Everything he says in games, I agree on.
That's
find
good.
Someone like that. That's not everybody agrees with Ryan. Not everybody plays the game.
Well,
Ryan
has to.
That's
right
my
yeah, you
don't
I love
what
this.
Are yours? You know
Ryan's
what I mean?
Ryan's good. Like, well, the same thing he said with Halo 4. I
screw
love.
The score.
It's just, yeah.
He gave like Halo 4 what a 9.7?
Something like that.
Good. Mine I probably gave him 9.5, but I don't care what he
you
talked about. It's a
on
score.
The same page.
It's a score.
Yeah.
Here's a good example. Final Fantasy 15, there's controversy. It's being an average of an 8. Does that make not a great game? No, to me I give it a damn 10. Because that is exactly what I wanted from
well,
the
yeah,
game.
What's funny
I watched the anime. I watched the movie. I'm loving the story.
It's
I
funny
like the
because
characters.
They're just
that's
they're
my
giving,
opinion.
They're giving the rank just for the game. If you watch the movie
yep.
and stuff, it helps it
give
it a
yes,
better
do
score.
Not play that game unless you've watched the anime and the movies. Especially the movie. Do not play
yeah,
that without
what,
watching the movie.
That's what people, you're not,
some like, people are selling
they're like, the story is complicated and not, you can't understand.
No,
like,
no,
that's
no,
because you didn't
said,
watch the movie.
They said you don't have much character development. You don't know what's going on.
And there is. Watch the material.
All right.
But good point, Heather.
That's it for our review for this. I mean, we have tons. I mean, and we're gonna go
we'll
back to our
about,
regular.
We'll talk about it later.
We'll go back to our regular episode starting next week. We're gonna talk about how
PlayStation Experience.
PlayStation Experience.
Oh yeah.
Hideki. I mean, Anno, the guy that directs Evangelion, how he's suing Gainax for royalties. There's all this stuff we have to talk about. We'll talk about
the
it.
The guy
in
from
our next,
Seven Deadly Sins is sick.
Yeah,
the
Seven Deadly Sins sick. Tons of other stuff.
Dragon Ball Super Trunks Arc review.
Yeah, yep.
Trunks Arc review.
We'll
do
a review about that too soon.
Uh huh. So we'll get to this. So signing off. This is David the Smash Fan.
Crazy Mommy Heather.
Miles your tech guy.
This is Worldwide.
Jose. This is Chibi the Podcast.
Dark Souls 3 loser.
Have a good night.
Good luck, guys.
Jesus.